Welcome back to Living 808. Have you seen the movie Under the Tuscan Sun? If you haven't, you need to. It's based on the book with the same name, and the author of that book, Frances Mayers, joins us today. She'll be on Maui tomorrow evening hosting a Toast to Tuscany event. Good morning, Frances. Thank you for joining us. And I was just asking you over the break, but we shall let the viewers know that Under the Tuscan Sun, the book, was actually a memoir.
Yes. Everything totally true in the book. Of course, they changed things for movies.
Yeah, of course, for Hollywood's sake.
Yes.
But I got really excited about that because one of my favorite movies, and I will now have to read the book. Tell us a little bit about your background.
Well, most of my life was spent in the South, mm-hmm. in Georgia, and then my grown-up life in San Francisco. But in 1990, I made this enormous move and bought an abandoned house in Tuscany and set about restoring it and writing about living in a foreign country, getting to know a new language. It was all just so exciting that I kept writing. I've written 8 books about Italy.
Wow. And so it just started out as just writing in your journal? Is that what it was? Or were you trying to write a book?
Yeah, well, early on, yes. I started writing about just all the experiences we were having because everything was such a discovery.
Mm-hmm.
And it just kept growing. And suddenly there was a book, and then there was another one and another one.
What a whirlwind of a life it's been, I'm sure.
Yes.
What inspired you to start Tuscan Sun Wines?
Well, after living in Italy for all those years and tasting thousands and thousands of wines, mm-hmm. I really wanted to bring back to America that sense you have when you're sitting in a little piazza and you just have this glass of wine that seems like it'll transform your life. And mm-hmm. then you get home and you can't find that wine, that mm-hmm. simple, wonderful wine that just goes with food. And so I searched all my sources for 5 wines that I felt really enhanced food, enhanced good company, and they were in the Tuscan spirit, really drink me now wines.
Oh.
So they're all really available wines, and you pick them up on Wednesday night and you pour it that night. You don't have to wait 5 years.
Right. Okay, so is it something that happens with the way that it's processed? I mean, how does it differ from the ones here?
Well, I think there's something about the Tuscan sun that just gets into those grapes and gets into the bottles. So I think of these bottles as almost like they're full of the Tuscan sun. That, you know, the word terroir, you hear mm-hmm. that word all the time. Well, the wines really have that. They taste like the place they came from.
Right, okay. Well, there's this event happening in Maui, Taste in Tuscany. Now, how was your wine chosen for this event? I it's probably a dumb question, actually.
No, it's because it's such a wonderful wine.
Yeah, it is, I'm
they,
sure.
The Westin group invited us. We're just bringing the wines into Hawaii now. We go state by state. So we're bringing them, and we thought this would be such a celebratory occasion to have these great chefs who are going to be coming up making wonderful wines that paired so well with food. And mm-hmm. And it's on Maui. I've never been there, so it's very exciting.
Oh, good. Well, I'm sure they will welcome you with open arms. And thank you so much for joining us this morning. It really was such a treat. And again, if you haven't gotten the chance to read Under the Tuscan Sun, you must, so we can read about your life.
Thank you.
Because it seems really exciting. And we're going to toss it on over to Taizo, who's mm-hmm. going to give us a little bit of that taste.
Yeah, that's right. Chef Jim and Chef Alvin getting stuff ready. But I'm actually joined by someone very special, Jim Hansen, who's going to kind of give us a little know-how. Now, you're at Pūlehu restaurant, you're the manager, but also you're in charge of the wine list, right?
Yes, I have that really rough job. I'm in charge of the wine list.
It was amazing. When you're opening up these bottles, I must say, I wish people could smell at home. She's not joking about the smell. The scents, the grapes, the fruity flavors you could smell right here.
Absolutely. It's a sense of place. It says Tuscany.
Now, real quickly, I can hear the chefs cooking things up, but the event itself, tickets still available. Where can they go? What should people know about the event itself, sir?
Well, the event is going to be amazing. You can get the tickets at HonoluluBoxOffice.com, and it's going to be Frances, 4 different wines, 4 courses, and we're going all out. We've had a huge movie screen, and we're going to put in our koi pond, and we're going to watch the movie about her life under the Tuscan sun.
And you can't get much better location than that. I mean, it's such a wonderful place. Now, I got to say, we'll get a little bit later, but the chefs, the food that's going to be there. And I got to say, how important is the food when it comes to pairing with great wine like this? How does that, the thinking behind that start?
Well, great food and great wine makes it easy, all right? So it's a little bit harder when you have one is lacking. But, you know, Francis has made some very approachable, wonderful wines. And we get to just enjoy them. And it's like an Italian backyard picnic that we're just going to have at our restaurant. It's going to be wonderful.
You know, the Italian culture about enjoying wine, enjoying food, taking our time. You can't get much better location than your restaurant, I must say. I've seen it. It's a beautiful place.
Oh, thank you. Mm-hmm. And also, you know, the Italian culture marries with our culture in Hawaii, and especially on Maui, where it is about relaxation. It's about enjoyment. It's about ohana and all about the terroir and the aina.
Ah, I love it. It does make sense. The cultures both mix. Now, I got to ask, as chefs are mixing here, we're going to kind of taste what they're making later, but what are they going to be making today for us? Do you know what we're cooking up
right
here?
Oh, my gosh. We're so lucky that we have a risotto with pork belly, and then we have fresh manchong. It's going to be great.
I got to ask, too, what is it like for you being on Maui, such a great place, but showcasing local food and local chefs like this with wine that's world famous? I mean, it's kind of a unique coming together, isn't it?
Oh, absolutely. And when I started at Pūlehu, I weighed 180 pounds. I weigh a few more pounds now, but I'm just so fortunate.
Yeah, and again, tickets still available. One more time, I want to say we have the information on our website, but where can people go for tickets? Because this thing, I got to be honest with you, with the people who are attending and all the good food, it might sell out very quickly.
I think it's going to sell out very quickly today. HonoluluBoxOffice.com for the last, I think there's 17 tickets left.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so it's going to be great.
All right. Well, we're going to come back a little bit later and taste some of this delicious food. But again, get on our website, get there, because these tickets will go quick. And it's a wonderful, really once-in-a-lifetime opportunity over on Maui. Now, come